what's happening, world? Kid Buck Billions, man. I know a lot of cats, they be out there in these relationships. You know what I'm saying? But I want you to ask yourself, in the relationship that you in, is it love or is it lust? Let me give you a fictional story on it.
Not real.
Listen. Hey, shorty was bad. Weighed 130 pounds, height 5'5". Incredible body, killing the town. Light skin, a ghetto chick with a bougie style. And the looks, I ain't gonna talk about the cutie smile. Cheer, no doubt about it, lil' mama was fine. But the best thing about it, lil' mama was mine. She knew that me being a man, I wasn't into it. So we decided to become friends with just benefits. A few months came up, we started to get serious. And love flamed up like the tip of a cigarette. Me being in love, nah, I wasn't really feeling it. But can't even front, I was starting to get a feel of it. A conversation and a touch had me stuck in the day. But stuck so high, I started fucking up on my grades. A's and B's turned to F's and D's. Off the SCX, we used to sex every week. I sing.
All of a sudden we was hanging out, just kept thinking about laying down. That's when you really tried to change my style. I said I can't even go right now, but then I gave that thought a second chance, cause I really want to be your man. Mind and my heart just had to change, but that's
get back to
okay.
Now remember that last verse when shit was all peaches and cream. Well, it's the U-turn to show you everything ain't what it seemed. I had to make moves, hit the road and do shows. And since we wasn't close, I was out being a hoe. Was enjoying myself, kicking it with them other broads. Every city I visited, different panties and bras. And I can't lie, I ain't want my shorty to be involved. That's why I didn't reply to none of her texts or missed calls. When we did chat, it'd be the average couple conversation. Her asking me the basics, what I did and how my day went. I tell her just hit the stage or was grinding in the studio, but didn't include the part when I was grinding in the goofy hoes. Now I understood that I was at a risk of taking the loss, but understood it wasn't cheating if I didn't get caught. So I continue to cheat, letting them bears jerks. But that ain't the end the story contains in the next verse.
All of a sudden things are changing now. Said goodbye and went away for a while. Baby, I'm sorry, but I'm dipping now. So many females is feeling my style. Being away is playing games on my mind. Confused if I wanna be with you or not. Missing your calls about 3 or 4 times, but that's okay.
But now you women probably thinking he a dog and he a hoe. Well, let me finish before you speak, it's more that you need to know. I start realizing the shit I did was wrong, probably cause I was packing on my way home. Touchdown at the crib, I hit her on the phone just to see who she was with and just to see what she was on. She replied, boy, plus I got the crib for the weekend. With that being said, you know what I was thinking. She ain't know I was in the land, I wanted to surprise her. Cell phone, pressed it in and hopped up in the shower. Hit the floors, caught flowers. A crib I arrived at, but once I stepped in, that's when shit got sour. Walked up the stairs, smelled cologne in the air.
Probably you.
Nah, this one the type of shit I wear. Made an entrance in the room with the flowers in my hand. Pulled the covers back, this bitch doing the nasty with my mans. Like, damn. Now how do I react to this situation? Do I get mad at my nigga? Get mad at my girl? My nigga, my girl. You know they say what goes around comes around. And when it comes around, it comes back twice as hard. Now don't get it twisted. This situation didn't take place in my life personally. It's just a situation that takes place in a life's perspective. You feel me? Now, you need to ask yourself. I bet you're thinking, now, damn, is it love? Is it lust? It's just food for thought. Just vibe with me.